This journey goes way back 50 years when I was given the key to a safe. In those days, the money was never banked. It was always rolled up in a cloth bag and asked to be placed there. But as children, you explore what's inside. You know, you start finding things. And what came out, to my surprise, were some notes which had Reserve Bank of India on it, and the note said Pakistan notes, payment refused. So I did ask my granddad, what is this and why is it Pakistan? All he did was abuse, because somebody gave him this money, and then when he went to bank it, they said this money belonged to Pakistan, and he refused. This did not stop there. And one day, while my uncle was sitting on his desk, he pulled out a few old bank notes. And when I saw them, my eyes lit up. And I asked him, if you don't mind, can you part with these? So he gave it to me. Once he gave it to me, now it was a starter kit. And in that, there was a 2.5 rupees or 2 rupees 8 annas note. And that denomination fascinated me. So the collection became a hobby, and I started trying to find out how to get more of these notes. What was a hobby became a passion, and passion became an obsession. And the excitement has come because, you know, the 50 years that I put in into this hobby, the knowledge that I gained, the more you come to know, the more excitement it is. And it's not a single day, maybe in the last 20 years, where I haven't spent 2 or 3 hours doing research. Now when the collection reached to a point where it is so huge and so intense, I wanted to start a museum. See, money is an aspect of life which is very important to all. When you're in the museum, what you will see is that how money has transformed or grown from where it started to where it is today. And it teaches you the transformation of how the country has progressed, and it takes you through the different regions of the country where people will learn that, you know, this is an aspect that has brought people together. The plan to make a museum was never there. That thought got seeded sometime in the year 2010 or 2011. This is a heritage for the country. It is a gift to the nation. It is something that, you know, the children and everyone else will come to learn about our culture, about our heritage, and they'll be proud when they go back that, you know, such a thing exists. The museum has some spectacular artifacts which will amaze even a child or a person who's just a visitor to the site. To an ardent collector, it's very different because, you know, he's not even seen it. He's probably seen an image. He's not physically seen something at a distance. I'm very excited about the artifacts that are there in the museum. I have something called the Star of India. There was a medal given by the British to the royalty. That Star of India is used as a watermark in the first portrait series. There was also things like the earliest known banknote, which is dated 5th September 1812. You can see that note. There are few notes of very high denomination notes. We had 10,000 rupee notes way back in the 1800s. Every note tells a story. There is a vignette or a motif which shows how the country has moved in time. Also, it's very important to say that, you know, whether we are in Kashmir or whether you are in Kanyakumari, the common factor is not the language, it is the note.